BBC Radio Scotland.
Listen on BBC Sounds.
You're listening to Ashley Storrie on BBC Radio Scotland live from Pacific Quay, joined as always by sidekick Silent Paul. We have entered the third and final hour of the show and we have scores for our Hollywood swinger Brie Larson. If you've just tuned in, you're like, which Hollywood swinger she's talking about and who's Brie Larson? Listen to the BBC Sounds app or website, The Ashley Storrie Show, and you can hear it all again. And Brie Larson sang a song and it was great, and now we're judging it on a scale of would only sell.
Yes, so yours is a step down from the Carfrae.
Yeah, but whenever Gordon Ramsay goes to restaurants on Kitchen Nightmares, what are the three things he says?
Less items on the menu.
Uh-huh. Source local ingredients. Declutter your restaurant. So it's like, nailed it.
I don't think Carfrae's are confusing.
It is for me. Do you know what? Gordon Ramsay's a huge fan of BBC Radio Scotland. He's always listening. Loves Stuart and Tam. Maybe he's listening just now. What do you think of my idea for just a roast chicken restaurant? And also, what would you call it? Get in touch via text 80295. Thank you so much, Gordon Ramsay. We have got a message.
Sells medieval cheese.
Ooh, no, my cheese would be the kind of the real stuff from back in the ACBC days. We've got a message here from Robson who says, hi you two, Brie Larson gets 92 Kenny Rogers roasters from me tonight, huzzah. Emily has went to her bed, but she might be listening to the show in her room. Emily, Robson wants you to know that he loves you more than anything in the world, and he'll be supporting you through every step of your journey, and he's always going to be there for you. Aww. And Emily, I'm sending you a big over the airways cuddle right now. I'm putting my arms out and I'm giving you a squeeze. I hope you enjoy it. Alan's been in touch and says, external, think before clicking. Brie Larson, fabulous. 100 Kenny Rogers roasters. Yes, Alan, yes. Thank you, Alan, for getting in touch. Who's this from? Jane Jones. Hi, Ashley and Paul. Agent Anent, not agent.
Agent Brie Larson.
Agent Brie Larson. Anent Brie Larson. The song wasn't...
For the CIA, the cheese. Cheese are you.
Ooh, the song wasn't for me, generational thing, but she performed it no so bad. So I will award her 75 Kenny Rogers roasters to Miss Larson before you ask. I've never heard of her.
I didn't think
Jane
so.
Jones, we didn't think you had. And in pasta, it's generally accepted that Marco Polo brought pasta back. The pool game man?
Yeah.
Was he a real person?
Yeah, he was a navigator.
Why is that a thing you play in a swimming pool where you shut your eyes?
Because he was obviously involved in the water business.
Are you kidding me?
I mean, I'm surmising, but...
This is when I found out that Lois Lane and Clark Kent were the name of the explorers who discovered America.
What?
Lois and Clark discovered America.
All right.
Anyway, I always got so confused and thought they were talking about Superman. Right, Marco Polo...
I thought it was Lewis and Clark.
I mean, I've heard it both ways. Marco Polo brought pasta back from China, where he encountered noodles. Do you think he found them when Marco's been around the market, right? And he's in China and he's like, oh, I've discovered this new land. And people are like, try this, it's called noodles. And he's like, oh, that tastes good. Too complicated to say. We call it pasta. Do you think he did that?
I now need to just, you keep asking me questions that I need to find out the answer.
Jim Jones, thank you so much for giving us much to think about. Much to think about from Jane Jones. We've got another message about pasta.
It's from Jane Jones again.
And then pasta. Strike the Marco Polo story. Why didn't you open this one first?
Because it came after.
Strike the Marco Polo story. Apparently the Romans were making forms of pasta and the word comes from ancient Greek meaning barley porridge. Jane Jones, didn't I tell you, didn't I say that back in the olden days there would be Greeks or Romans making some sort of paste out of a grain and making it into a pasta? Didn't I tell you, didn't I say, Paul? Yes, I did. He won't admit it because he's too busy being wrong in his wrongness.
Every single thing that we've typed in indicates that what we were actually talking about, the mixing of cheese.
We cannot use Wikipedia as a source when
articles.
Jane Jones exists.
BBC Good Food.
But I'm so sorry that the place where Ainsley Harriet puts his recipes hasn't given us the proper historical roots of a cheese stroke pasta. I've got a message from Billy. I can't believe we're fighting about this, and I can't believe we've been fighting about this for nearly 2 hours. Billy says, hi guys, I've requested a paramedic to rush to Pacific Way as Ashley is clearly about to hyperventilate over Brie Larson. I'm more likely to hyperventilate over the fact that Paul wouldn't admit that I was right, that cheesy pasta dates back to the olden days of ACBC. Sadly, in the Larson Moors, I'm manning the barricade with Paul and awarding a generous but just 50 Kenny Rogers roasters to Mrs. Average. Aye, yours, Billy. I'm too worked up about cheese to care about that right now. And on that subject, Carrie has said, for heaven's sake, Paul, give Ashley some cheese, says Carrie in Oklahoma. Oh, I'd love cheese right now. Do you know what's the weirdest thing? I was literally looking at cheese all day today.
Just as a hobby?
I was on the internet and I'm thinking
like
about...
Like a cheese catalogue?
Pretty much. Thinking of buying myself a cheese box for Christmas.
Is this a box filled with cheese or a box, you know, when you buy a bread bin and it's got bread written on it? Is it just a box to put cheese in?
No, it's a box that comes with cheeses.
Right.
So like 6 cheeses and a wine pairing. Mm-hmm. But I was just going to eat it myself and drink it myself. And it says it's for 4 people. But I think if I take that as like a long distance run and just start in the morning... and drink and eat cheese until nighttime. I mean, my tummy will hurt, but I'll be happy. And I was thinking about doing that. So that's what I was thinking about all day today. Get in touch via text at 0295. Let us know what you thought of Brie Larson. I'm going to put on the next song. Oh, it's a good one, isn't it, Paul? We have missed the whole point of this show completely. We stopped talking about what our topic was about 25 minutes into this when we start to talk about cheese.
I can't remember topics half the time.
Paul, about 60 people are on Facebook right now. Other sites are available. Be like, my favourite cosy thing and my favourite cosy food is blah, blah, blah. We haven't read any of them.
I like my soft pyjamas I've had since I was 16.
Yep, lots of people with lots of answers like that and we haven't given them any attention because what have we been fighting about? Cheese. And who was right? Ashley.
Wait a minute. When were you...
When I was right. When Jane Jones said
No, all she said was when that was invented.
So if pasta was invented in the Roman times and cheese was invented in the Greek times, you're telling me that at no point ever did somebody mix cheese and pasta together in that archipelago of time?
Nah.
You're wrong! I want to take off my shoe and throw it at you. You're so wrong. I want to Alex Ferguson you.
I just don't think they'd ever had made a cheese sauce.
You don't have to make a cheese sauce to have a cheesy pasta, Paul. You can just mix... You're deliberately antagonising me.
So what you're saying is you would have pasta and then just
grate cheese
just
in it?
Just grate cheese
yes,
over the top
all
of
the
it
time.
Dried pasta?
So you're saying they didn't boil pasta?
Yeah, but it's
so
still
they invented
just...
pasta but they never boiled it, Paul?
Yeah, you dry it out. Well, you're just slapping it on the plate right out of the water. You've got to put thing in a colander first.
So do you think that the Romans who invented aqueducts and wiping their butt couldn't work out how to drain a pasta and were just like, oh, serious, let's eat water with dry wheat? You're an idiot. Here's Rod Stewart and Dolly Parton with Baby It's Cold Outside.